people of India. This is not just a phrase. It is the first line of our preamble, a line that defines us, shapes us, and binds us all Indians together. 26th November 1950 was the day when the Indian Constitution came into effect, and it is a historic moment this year because this year we are celebrating 70 years of that historic day. Hello and welcome to Y Factor. I'm Shreya Upadhyay, and today in this episode we'll be talking to youngsters about what constitution means to them, how they interpret it, and what challenges are faced by the Indian constitution in today's time. Let's begin this conversation. With 1,45,000 words, the Indian Constitution is the longest in the world. And as we celebrate 70 years of the Indian Constitution coming into effect, I am joined by youngsters, young professionals, students from across the country. And let's talk to them about what they think of the Constitution, how they interpret our Indian Constitution. Hi, what's your name?
Prastuti Sharma.
And where are you from?
I'm from Delhi itself.
You're a student?
Yes, ma'am.
So, you know, first and foremost, I'll just ask you what you think, what meaning does the Indian Constitution hold for you?
Well, it's a document which is telling us how to run this country and how to lead our lives as citizens. That's what I think of Constitution. And yeah, I'm proud of our Constitution. And since it's very exclusive and inclusive at the same time, our Constitution is giving us the largest democracy of the world. So, yeah.
What do you mean when you say exclusive as well as inclusive? I understand the inclusive part, but what do you mean when you say that it's exclusive as well?
By exclusive, I mean it's open to amendments, but whereas our officials do certify that we don't change the base of the Constitution, but we are open to amendments as the time moves forward.
All right, so basically, you know, it's an open document. It is open to change, open to amendments. And over the years, we have seen several amendments being done to the Indian Constitution. For you guys, you know, what does the Indian Constitution represent?
Ma'am, for me, I'm a youngster and I've just gotten to 18. And since I voted for the first time in 2019, so for me, I got the chance to analyze the politics more nicely through constitution, through which we constitution, that's how it helps us to make government run the country. It isn't the vice versa that government runs the country on its own, but the government is stays within the peripheral of constitution to run this country with equality and etc.
So basically, it's a citizen charter for not just the citizens but the government as well, to, you know, run the country, to see how things can be changed, things can come into effect in the country. You, I believe, are a principal of a school.
Yeah, definitely.
And you know, how do you see the students in your school? How do they see the constitution? And how, first of all, as a principal, how do you see the Indian Constitution?
See, actually, I'm a principal, so I see the constitution as that it is not just only about the what means not only the rules. I see it for the students as well, that what we should do for our nation, it is more important than the rules and regulations as well. We know as that it is our constitution, but if we are not following the, if we are not doing our duty as self, so I think there is no means of any constitution of the earth. So I see like that.
And you know, there over the years there has been a lot of awareness among youngsters, among students, especially about the constitution of the country. In your school, how do you see students, you know, talking about this, interacting about and discussing the constitution?
Yeah, it's also based on the school as well, that the CBSC and the other books has also given the first page for the constitution. Hum Bharat ke log, like that. So our students enjoy these things.
Absolutely. I think that's the good part, you know, that students, youngsters, youth is getting aware of the Indian constitution, of what it holds, the articles, the fundamental rights and duties. But for you guys, you know, what is that one thing that stands out for you in the Indian constitution?
सबसे पहले तो मैं इस देशवासियों को संविधान दिवस की बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं देना चाहता हूं, और ये भी बताना चाहता हूं कि हमारे संविधान ने महिलाओं को, बच्चों को, गरीब को, अमीर को, सबको इक्वल राइट दिए हैं, उसमें समानता का अधिकार दिया है, स्वतंत्रता का अधिकार दिया है, और ये दुनिया में पहला ऐसा संविधान है जो लिखित है और जिसमें ये प्रावधान है कि आप उसको समय समय पर वक्त के अनुसार आप उसको उसमें चेंज कर सकते हैं, जिससे कि जो आम जनता है उसके उसके फायदे के लिए जो भी होगा वो सरकार करेगी। उसके लिए ये संविधान उस बात की गारंटी देता है कि कभी भी कोई ऐसा मामला रहेगा कि जिसमें पब्लिक एट लार्ज को यदि कोई नुकसान हो रहा है तो उसमें संविधान संसद के द्वारा संविधान में संशोधन किया जा सकता है।
सो यू नो फंडामेंटल राइट्स एंड ड्यूटीज बीइंग गिवन टू अस थ्रू द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड वी ऑल नो यू नो द काइंड ऑफ हार्ड वर्क दैट हैज गॉन इनटू इट, ऑल्दो वी हैव बोरोड अ लॉट ऑफ आवर इंस्टेंसेस इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन फ्रॉम फ्रांस एंड ब्रिटेन एंड द यूएस, बट वी नो दैट इट्स अ वेरी यू नो कॉम्प्लेक्स holy book so as to say for all of us as citizens of India, but you know he mentioned a very important thing. He talked about the women being given their rights in the Indian Constitution. As a young girl you know this new India, how do you see that? Do you think that there are, of course there are you know rights being given to women, but the interpretation of these rights have you know still they have you know far to go?
Ma'am, like sir said that women have all the rights to voting and other things, like they can participate in everything in sports and others. As I'm a sports player, so I have faced so many difficulties, but as our constitution gives us every rights and I'm played nationals and all things. So as I'm a student of Delhi University, I'm studying legal literacy in where we studied about human rights. See how courts and how police helps us to maintain these rights and everything. So I think that women have all the rights and they are achieving heights because of that. And our constitution is kind of, we are Indians and there's unity in diversity. So we all are following the same constitution, knowing that we have the diversity in our country, we have different languages, we have other things, but still we are following the same constitution. So I think this is the greatest achievement of our country, that we are following the constitution and our women get all the rights and they are achieving heights.
Absolutely, I think she brought out a very beautiful point, something that we all celebrate as Indians, that is unity in diversity. How do you see this you know diversity being celebrated in the Indian constitution? We know that you know every nook and corner of our country has a different language, different food habits, you know, different rituals. How do you see that coming into effect through the Indian constitution?
There is difference between constitution and the constitutionalism. As we talk about the constitution is a separate part to run a government. Being a follower of the constitution, we have to follow constitutionalism also, because the one nation, one constitution, one India make us strong, and it will give us a identity on the international level also. Constitution is not only a holy book for us, it's everything for us, because if you talk about the sovereign, constitution is the sovereign. Like if you talk about the parliament and the Supreme Court, no, we are following the constitution and it gives us an identity how to run, how to improve a life of a human being, a citizen of India. Like we have started the preamble of the constitution of India. It starts from the we the people of India. When there were debate in the constitutional assembly, some were saying that you should start it from the in the name of God, in the name of Allah, in the name of that person. No. But Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar has rightly said that we means because we have taken we of the preamble of Indian constitution from the UN. No. It includes everyone, male, female, even. And one more very beautiful thing of Indian constitution which you will not find out in entire world, it only not give rights and liabilities to the men's and the women's, it gives right and liabilities to the forest, living creature and unliving creature also, forest animals and the unliving creatures also.
Yeah, that's you know, that's the beautiful part of our Indian constitution. We have been talking about it. For you guys, what does it represent? What are the key holding points of the Indian constitution for you?
जैसे कि डॉक्टर साहब ने बताया कि कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के पहले ही पन्ने पे लिखा है वी द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया, इसका मतलब है कि कोई एक व्यक्ति, कोई धर्म, कोई जात, कोई भी जेंडर ये कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन नहीं बनाता, ये देश हम सब मिलके बनाते हैं, चाहे वो किसी भी जाति का हो, बिरादरी का हो, जेंडर का हो, दलित हो, शोषित हो, वोट का अधिकार हम सभी को इक्वल वोट का अधिकार ये संविधान देता है, और ये संविधान किसी भी बाइबल, किसी गीता, कुरान, किसी चीज़ से नहीं चलता, ये संविधान से चलता है, ये बताता है कि हमें संविधान ही सर्वोपरि है, सबसे ऊपर है, और देश संविधान चलता है।
You know, despite immense varieties of caste, color, creed in our country. We know that the Indian Constitution binds us all together. We go above and beyond it, and we take it as the holy book, as the citizen charter, as I have been saying, the Indian Constitution. But what do you think, you know, in today's time, are the challenges in implementing the kind of rights that our Indian Constitution provides to us?
Actually, ma'am, I think we have our rights, we have our duties, and as a responsible citizen, we have to focus that we don't have to always talk about the rights. We do have our certain duties. And actually, I am from Uttarakhand and I came to Delhi. I was so fascinated by the archaeological places and everything. When I went to them, they were all scarred with the names, and like that's a basic duty to protect our heritage. And where are we as youths are progressing in that? So let us not talk about the rights first. Let us think what we are giving to the country. Let us not ask what the constitution is doing to us or for the country's
good. Yes, absolutely. I'm so glad that you brought this up. And that's, you know, a very fantastic thing that you are saying as a young citizen of the country, that more than our rights, we should be first focusing on our duties as the citizens of this country. And like you said, you know, our archaeological monuments, they're all scarred, and the Prime Minister keeps talking about it, that we should keep them clean, we should visit them as often as possible. For you guys, what do you think, you know, are the challenges? Like he said, we should focus on our duties, because we have a lot of freedoms given to us, whether it is, you know, freedom to expression, freedom to, you know, innumerable freedoms that we've got through the Indian Constitution. But we know that no freedom comes without responsibility.
Without responsibility and without restrictions also. Like, I want to use my freedom, but I cannot point out anyone on the basis of the caste, class, color, gender and the economic basis. So, like, if you talk about the freedom of speech, we cannot blindly say anything to anyone on the social media or anywhere. It comes with the responsibilities or restrictions also. Because, like, we are talking about the right and the duties. The pollution, like, we are living in Delhi. Everyone talk about the right. Pollution is right, but who will fulfill their duties? When we will fulfill our duties, we will get pollution-free air in Delhi. We will have a good environment to live in Delhi, because we are living in a gas chamber. We are living in gas chamber because of our rights, not duties.
Absolutely, we have to focus on our responsibilities. You know, you as a principal have an everyday interaction with students, and over the few years we have been seeing youngsters talking about freedom of expression so much. How do you guys you know, tell them about this freedom of expression and the kind of responsibility that comes along with it?
ये अपने आप में बहुत महत्वपूर्ण है, क्योंकि ये एक ऐसी एज है जब बच्चों को पता है कि हाँ, अब मैं एक्सप्रेशंस, मतलब मैं फ्रीडम ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन है मेरे पास. हमारे लिए यहाँ पे ये बड़ा महत्वपूर्ण हो जाता है कि हम उसको इस तरीके से बताएं कि इसमें डिफरेंस क्या है, कि क्या बोलना है, क्या नहीं बोलना है. ये भी अपने आप में बहुत ज़रूरी है. अच्छा, इसी के साथ साथ एक बहुत महत्वपूर्ण जो बात मैं कहना चाहूँगा, राइट टू एजुकेशन, ये भी एक संविधान का एक हिस्सा है. राइट टू एजुकेशन ही है जिसने कई देहाती क्षेत्रों में, जहाँ पे कई रूढ़िवादिता ने हावी है लोगों पर, लेकिन संविधान ने उनको अधिकार दिया कि आप जाएंगे पढ़ने. अब 14 साल से नीचे का बच्चा नहीं काम कर सकता है, उसके स्कूल में जाना ही जाना है. ये संविधान का हिस्सा है. तो संविधान का ये जो राइट टू एजुकेशन वाला हिस्सा, ये मेरा बहुत फेवरेट है और आई अप्रिशिएट दिस.
तो आप, यू नो, बच्चों से जब बात करते हैं, कि इंटरेक्शन होती है, इस चीज़ को, यू नो, ये चीज़ कैसे समझते हैं आजकल के बच्चे, कि फ्रीडम ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन क्या चीज़ है, उसके साथ जो रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी आती है वो क्या चीज़ है?
बहुत बहुत टफ है अपने आप में बच्चों के लिए बेसिकली, और हमारे लिए बड़ा टफ है कि उनको किस तरीके समझाना, क्योंकि एज एक ऐसी, उन्हें लगता है कि नहीं, हम जो कर रहे हैं वो वाकई में सही है. अब फ्रीडम ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन की अगर हम बात करें, तो उन्हें पता है, मैं बहुत, मतलब एक बहुत माइनर से एग्जांपल करें, मतलब एक क्लास का, हमें, हम बात करने के लिए स्वतंत्र हैं, लेकिन वहीं पे उन्हें ये बताने कि ड्यूरिंग द टाइम ऑफ द स्टडी आपको नहीं बात करनी है, आपको शांत रहना है.
एंड दैट इज द इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट, दैट वी एज एडल्ट्स, यू नो, मेक आवर किड्स अंडरस्टैंड दैट दीज आर द स्मॉल थिंग्स दैट आर इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन गारंटीज, एंड दैट्स व्हाट वी शुड टेक केयर ऑफ व्हेन वी प्रैक्टिस आवर राइट्स एज सिटीजंस ऑफ द कंट्री. फॉर यू, यू नो, व्हाट इज the challenging thing of, you know, implementing the Indian Constitution? We know that there are freedom, we know there are responsibilities, but how far do you think people of your age are able to implement this?
Well, the basic thing comes to awareness. When they know what are their rights, then they'll understand what are their duties. See, your right is freedom of expression, but then you have to keep in mind that you don't hurt sentiments of other people. You express your opinion, keeping in mind that you're not being offended to anybody else. So this is what we have to learn, because basically nowadays even in media we see the debates are like they keep shouting at each other, saying any kind of remarks. What a formal way to express that is what we need to learn here. That is what I think our constitution wants us to do.
And you said, I'm glad that you said that the constitution wants us to do that, because a lot of times we take it for granted. We think that, okay, these are the rights, hum ye karne wale hain, but we don't forget, we don't remember our duties and responsibilities. Aap logon ke liye, kya maine rakhta hai, freedom, jitne hamare constitution mein de rakhe hain, aur uske saath saath jo unki responsibilities, unke saath jo duties aati hain wo.
According to me, these days people usually think practically, and what they do is they just go with their instincts ki agar koi dekh raha hai to theek hai, varna chalo. If they are stopping at a red light, police wala hai to theek hai, and varna chalo. But again, to teach people again and again the same things, government has to enforce laws, and that is something that people need to learn. If they are responsible enough to take initiatives and make others learn, then it's going to bring a change in the world.
So you're telling me कि आपने ऐसा कभी नहीं किया?
Trust me, ma'am, I have never done.
Okay, I'll take your word for it that you have not done it and you are a good citizen of the country. But for you, what does it mean to have our freedom as well as responsibilities and duties?
I have heard a quote popularly that your freedom exists to the other person's nose. Like, you can have your freedom, but let it not affect the other person. Like, he has got his individual freedom too, and we are given the right to freedom to expression. Actually, we are all different individuals, and we differently interpret the information we have. Like, one would take a meaning out of another meaning out of the same sentence. So basically, it doesn't mean that you have a different opinion, so you're wrong. You have an opinion, the other person has an opinion. You have to respect that fact too. So your freedom doesn't prove that you are right.
All right, he said something very interesting, that every line will have a different meaning for every citizen. A few of you are legal experts here, you are studying law. How do we get this consensus ki, mere liye jo line ek interpretation hai, wo dusre ke liye kuch aur ho sakti hai. And for a country to move together, there has to be one interpretation of one line of the constitution. How do we get that consensus? How does it work?
Na chalta hai desh mera. ना गीता ना कुरान से चलता है देश हमारा भारत के संविधान से. इफ़ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, वी हैव टू थिंक सिमिलर. वी हैव टू बियॉन्ड अवर कास्ट, बियॉन्ड अवर रिलीजन, बियॉन्ड अवर जेंडर. वी हैव टू थिंक अबाउट द वन नेशन.
Right, you I believe are a senior manager working in a bank. How do you see, the constitution providing for the youth? Because we know that at a very young age, a lot of people are becoming successful and they're, reaching heights, newer and newer heights in their lives. How do you think ki constitution mein youngsters ke liye provisions hai, to move ahead in life?
Dekhiye, jaise aap jante hain ki at a certain age, after 18, you become एलिजिबल. इन पास में आप देखिएगा कि कोई भी जॉब होती है, कोई भी ऑफिस होता है, हमेशा भाई भतीजावाद था. सभी लोगों को इक्वल मौके नहीं मिला करते थे. किसी को उठा के मेरा भतीजा है, उसको मैं बुलाया और जॉब पर रख लिया. बट आज ऐसा नहीं है. ड्यू टू कॉन्स्टिट्यूशंस मुझे उसका एडवर्टीजमेंट निकालना है. क्या उसमें रिक्वायरमेंट है वो मुझे शो करनी है. उनका एक सर्टेन पेपर सेट करना है और मेरिट पे मैंने कैंडिडेट सिलेक्ट करना है. अगर आज संविधान नहीं होता तो शायद मैं जहाँ पे हूँ वहाँ नहीं होता, और मेरे जैसे सैकड़ों लाखों लोग जो यहाँ पर हैं वो वहाँ पे नहीं होते. तो यूथ को ये संविधान में बिलीव करना है, ये विश्वास करना है कि अगर उसमें मेरिट है, अगर वो मेहनत करेगा तो उसको जॉब लाइफ में सक्सेस जरूर मिलेगी.
That's the key point here, that the youth have to believe in the Indian constitution. They have to put their faith in the constitution of India to move ahead. But we know that the members of the constituent assembly took so many years to draft the Indian constitution. They worked so hard day and night. For you guys, what importance does it hold for you in today's time, the Indian constitution? How do you think it has become even more important from the time of when it was implemented in 1950?
Well, I would like to bring up the point of RTI. Well, it has made a great change. Youth has a tendency to question everything, and RTI helps us to do that. And constitution makes government responsible for answering our questions.
So RTI is something that has, for you, it stands out from in the Indian Constitution. How do you guys see? आपको क्या लगता है कि Indian Constitution जब draft हुआ था, जब it came into effect, तब से लेके अब तक क्या कितनी importance बढ़ी है Indian Constitution की?
देखिए, जहाँ तक importance की बात है और इसके महत्व की बात हम ज़्यादा करते हैं, तो मैं इसमें एक बात आपको बताना चाहता हूँ कि जब इस संविधान को बनाया जा रहा था तो हमारे पूरे जो भारत का जो नक्शा है, जो बनाने वाले लोग थे, उन्होंने उसको कहाँ पर हमारे पहाड़ी क्षेत्र हैं, कहाँ पर हमारे समुद्र है, कहाँ पर हमारा रेगिस्तान है, कहाँ पर बर्फ है, ऐसी सारी विविधताओं को ध्यान में रखते हुए और हमारे जो जो देश की जो पॉपुलेशन है, हम जिसको कृषि प्रधान देश हम कहते हैं, उससे परिकल्पना थी, अब वो नहीं है, कंपैरेटिवली कम हुआ है, तो उन्होंने वो सारी चीज़ों को ध्यान में रखा कि हमको पर्यावरण का भी ध्यान रखना है, हमें लोगों को रोज़गार भी जो है प्रोवाइड कराना है, हमें लोगों की सुरक्षा भी करनी है, चाहे वो महिला हो और वो किसी भी तबके से जो है वो व्यक्ति आता हो.
So the very fact that you know that we're able to stand here, we're able to speak about all of this, do our everyday things in life, is thanks to the members of the Constituent Assembly who worked so hard to draft the Indian Constitution. But you know, 70 years, India has come a long way. When the constitution was drafted, we were a post-colonial country. We had just gotten independence. How far do you think we've come in terms of our constitution?
Like 2 year, 11 month, 18 days were taken at the time of the drafting of the constitution. Constitutional Assembly has taken such time. And the Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar has played key role. And as you said, that 1,45,000 words has been incorporated in the Indian Constitution. And the finest quality of our Constitution was that you won't believe that on each word and each comma, each dot, there were debate. And several debates were there.
So amendment is something that is, the strong point of the Indian Constitution, that it is open to change, and we can change it according to, our cultural norms and whenever we need. You have, like I asked him, he's also become a senior manager at a very young age. You're a school principal at such a young age. How do you see this journey of the Indian Constitution from when it was drafted to today's time?
अगर मैं बात करूं, एक 14 साल के बच्चे से कोई ज़बरदस्ती काम नहीं करवा सकता, क्योंकि अनुच्छेद 23 से 24 के बीच में है कि शोषण के विरुद्ध जो मतलब आप इसको कर ही नहीं सकते, 14 साल के बच्चे से नीचे काम ही नहीं करवा सकते. इसका मतलब उस पे एक ही चीज़ बचा, पढ़ लो. तो आज वो पढ़ सकता है. इतनी दूरदर्शिता, मतलब उस समय में जब शिक्षा का उतना मतलब मैं अगर कहूँ महत्व नहीं माना जा रहा था, लेकिन आज ये इतना की रोल प्ले कर रहा है एक बच्चे की लाइफ में.
It has played a key role, and there has been a very rich legacy of if we talk about Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who's considered the architect of the Indian Constitution. How do you guys see that legacy of the members of the Constituent Assembly? What do you think in today's time holds out, and we should remember from when they drafted the Indian Constitution? What should we remember from that hard work that they put in that time?
Actually, ma'am, when we look into that Constituent Assembly, we can see the people from every part of the country were there. So basically, from we had at the beginning respected the fact that we are a diverse country and we have to make it unified in oneself. So particularly when we started, I guess we know that the fact it is the longest written document in the world as for the fact. So we can just, can we just take that from, take this out of that fact that each and every value has been tried to be covered in that. Like, it has been like 70 years since the constitution, but I don't see the major changes. How far distance was their perspective of a nation. Like, it was genuinely a true fact as a constitution, as a nation that they developed, that still it's, the base is the same. Like, we can't ever question the base of a constitution, because when something is so appropriate for a nation, how can you just question that? Like, that is the example in itself. Like for the 70 years, the majority of the constitution is the same.
Right, and how do you see the legacy? How do you see this journey?
Ma'am, first of all, I'd like to mention that this constitution of ours is a tremendous example of a teamwork. At that time, when they took 3 years to made the draft, the difference between the first draft of our constitution and the final draft, almost 2,000 amendments were made. This shows the effort and the lot of discussions which would have gone into that. एंड द चेंज ऑफ मेंटालिटी हैज केम थ्रू इन दीज 70 ईयर्स व्हाट नेशन द ड्राफ्टिंग कमिटी वुड हैव सीन इन द फ्यूचर एंड सिंस देयर हैव बीन ओनली 100 अमेंडमेंट्स इन द लास्ट 70 ईयर्स एंड सो दैट शोज दैट वॉट दे थॉट हैड बीन सस्टेन्ड थ्रू द टेस्ट ऑफ टाइम एंड दिस certainly will do.
The members of the Constituent Assembly were so visionary in their drafting of the Indian Constitution that even today it holds importance. Even today we are living through the various facets of the Indian Constitution. All right, before I wrap this discussion up, I'll just play a little game with all of you. I'll say one word related to the Indian Constitution and you have to say the first thing that comes to your mind, okay? And you cannot take a lot of time. It's like a rapid fire, okay? One word I'll give and you have to say whatever comes to your mind, all right? Secularism.
Dynamic.
Socialism.
Constitution teaches us.
Dr. Ambedkar.
Genuine person and the famous personality.
Liberty.
Liberty in diversity.
Fraternity.
Indian Constitution.
Unity.
Bahut zaruri aaj ke samay mein.
The Indian Constitution.
The only one book of nation.
Preamble. Heart and soul of the Constitution. Well, this has been an enriching discussion and we are celebrating 70 years of the Indian Constitution coming into effect. As proud Indians, we know that we have a lot of freedoms which have been given us through the Indian Constitution, but we also should keep in mind that there are responsibilities and duties that come along with it. And as citizens, we should always remember it. That's it in Fire Factor this time, but we will come up with another interesting episode next week. But till then, you can send us your feedback and follow us at DD News Live. Thanks very much for joining us. Namaskar.
From being the longest to most democratic, it has the spirit of not you or I, but we. Hello and welcome to YFacts. I'm Shivali Khari and I'll bring you a small segment that will tell you the history and making of our constitution, the Indian Constitution. Here we go. The Constitution declares India to be a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic that offers its citizens justice, equality, and liberty. The fundamentals of the Constitution are contained in the preamble, which is also known as the preface to it, as it has all the major highlights of the Constitution. Well, let me tell you, Indian Constitution is the longest one in the world in any of the sovereign countries. It has a preamble, 448 articles, 25 parts and 12 schedules. It took almost 3 years to complete this constitution. The Constituent Assembly sat on 9th of December 1946 to write it down, and to be precise, it took 2 years, 11 months and 18 days to finish it. Do you know when the draft was made and put up for discussion and debate? Almost 2,000 amendments were made before it got finalized. The Constituent Assembly that drafted the Constitution made the Constitution in two languages. It was written in Hindi as well as English. The original Constitution is written in a flowing italic font with beautiful calligraphy. It was written by Prem Bihari Narayan Raizada. The original Constitution is handwritten, as I already said. Each page of the Constitution has been decorated beautifully by the artists from Shantiniketan, which includes of Nandalal Bose and Biohar Ram Manohar Sinha. The original copies of the Constitution are kept in the library of the Parliament of India, securely in the helium-filled cases. To summarize, the Democratic Constitution of India took almost 11 sessions to get complete. It got legally enforced on 26th of January 1950.